War Do You Lie? That's Malinky from their album Last Leaves. Welcome along to the Garden Sessions, episode 25. I'm Jack Foster, and with me, the folk scene's very own Richard and Judy. I don't know who writes this stuff, but it seems awfully hurriedly coupled together. I'm talking, of course, Tom Harland and Dave the Angles Gimble.
I don't know if I want to shotgun either this week. Angles. What's on the show, Jack?
This week we have the folky news, Dave's angle, the official Garden Sessions down the chart, letters bag, as well as all the best in new songwriting and traditional folk music. And also, a hello to all listeners of Radio Britfolk.
Welcome.
Becoming new listeners of the Garden Sessions. Tom, this week's featured artist.
This week's featured artist is Alan Hunter. Yeah. I believe a good word to describe Alan would be an abrasive performer.
An abrasive style and an abrasive performer.
Another great denizen of the Royal Oak pub, our local here in Edinburgh.
I met up with him last night in the Royal Oak, and we'll hear that later on.
Original song as well, and it's quite rare you hear Alan knock out an original. Mostly sticks with the traditional stuff.
You would think, but his original songs sound so traditional that they kind of pass.
I'm sure they do.
Angles, what's the next tune we're going to hear before we go to the folky news?
The next tune we're going to hear is Bedlam Boys by Pig's Ear.
Drink
Bedlam Boys by Pig's Ear. Very interesting lyric in that one about, was it hot mince pies from children's thighs?
That's what I thought I
heard.
Or
was it cut mince pies from children's thighs? All quite sinister. But anyway, Angles, I believe, you know a little bit about Pig's Ear. You want to make a Pig's Ear of this?
Thanks.
He doesn't know how to do it any other way.
Basically, Pig's Ear are made up of four of the members of the Rule family, and that's Grant Rule, Sue Rule, and their eldest daughter, Lindsay, and Uncle Bad Influence, says here. Keith Rule.
He must have been responsible for hot mince pies from children's thighs.
Surely.
That's probably when it came.
Uncle
Bad Influence.
And a pounding tune, Bedlam Boys. Angles, where can people find Pig's Ear on the internet?
If you want to try and find Pig's Ear anywhere on the internet, your best bet is MySpace. It's myspace.com/Pig's Ear.
Nice and easy to remember, I would say. Tom?
It's news! It's folk!
What is it, Tom?
It's the folky news!
And the Folky News brought to you this week, as ever, in association with Paddy Bart's Wee Folk Club.
Well, every Sunday night at the Oak, we've got the Wee Folk Club at 8:30, an intimate venue, 30 seats, acoustic. It's a great night out. We've got fantastic musicians and singers. Every Sunday night, do come along.
Sunday the 4th of March at the Wee Folk Club, it's Jez Lowe, one of the finest folk songwriters in the world, touring internationally with his band, The Bad Pennies.
Who, incidentally, Kate Bramley, a fellow Radio Brit folker, is part of Bad Pennies. We also played.
We played Kate last week, didn't we?
We did indeed. Yeah.
Nice. Mixing the traditional tunes of his native northeast England with powerful lyrics and a driving rhythmic style, Jez is at the cutting edge of contemporary folk music. And that's at the Royal Oak here in Edinburgh. And for more information, see royal-oak-folk.com. Moving on with the folky news. Lau's debut album, Lightweights and Gentlemen, is now finished and due for release on March the 19th on the mighty Reveal Records label. You can pre-order...
The mighty, yes.
You can pre-order that now to ensure one of the serial-numbered limited editions bonus track copies. There you go.
So now's the time to order.
Yes, indeed. Lau, who are playing at Celtic Connections, which we covered a few weeks ago, consists of Chris Drever, Orcadian multi-instrumentalist, from singing and guitar playing to banjo and double bass, has been in great demand since moving to Edinburgh in 1995. Martin Green as well. He shared the stage with many of the great singers and players of English music, including Martin Carthy, Norma Waterson, Catherine Tickell, Linda Thompson.
Got the pronunciation right there.
That first time I did, yeah. And a long-term collaboration with Eliza Carthy. Aidan O'Rourke, and also, he's a fiddle player and composer from Oban.
Fantastic musicians all.
Another good thing to look out for in the upcoming weeks is the Royal Oak Folk Festival. We attended last year. This is
always
from
fun.
16th March to the 15th of April that it runs. So it's quite a marathon folkathon, and indeed there is a folkathon on the 7th of April in aid of sick kids, live folk music all day, and it really is all day.
Tom and I will be performing during that folkathon as Lords of the Bothy. Angles, will you be along?
I'll probably be there.
Also, 9th of April is the songwriting competition. If you want to take part, you should submit lyrics, ideally 3 copies, to the Royal Oak. Entries must be in by the 2nd of April, and all artists must be able to perform their own songs on the night. Angles, will you be entering?
No? No way, no how.
Come on, the reigning champions aren't exactly...
28th of February in Edinburgh Folk Club. It's Rab Noakes. As a prolific singer-songwriter, Rab has released a dozen albums and toured extensively. He now combines this with eclectic activities at Neon. Rab tries to get on the road as a performer at least once a year, either with harmonica player Fraser Spears or solo. They've developed a unique act which covers a broad range of popular styles. As well as a helping of original Noakes material, they play a rich mixture of blues and country. The opening spot will feature Danny Kyle Award winners Winging It, a fine guitar duo from Perth and Orkney. Keep up to date with all the latest folky news, gardensessions.co.uk/news. And that's the folky news.
angles, how many climbers, how many non-movers, how many downers, how many re-entries, new entries?
Well, we've got a couple of re-entries again.
How exciting is the top 10?
It's pretty exciting.
The official Garden Sessions download chart. The official Garden Sessions download chart.
At 10, it's a non-mover for Random Scantum with Hush. At 9, it's a new entry for Jamie Laval and Ashley Broder with Piper's Reverie. At 8, it's a re-entry for the Laurie Watson 3 with When Maggie Gangs Away.
Oh, what will all the lads do when Maggie gangs away? Oh, what will all the lads do when Maggie gangs away? There's no hurt in all this glen that does not reach the day.
At 7, it's a non-mover for Andy Chung with The Wee Room. At 6, it's another re-entry for Jamie Laval and Ashley Broder with The Cuckoo in the Blackberry. At 5, it's up 4 for Four Chords and the Truth with Old Men Fall in Love. At 4, it's down 1 for Frank Burkitt featuring Cara Philby with Old Timer.
Then we break into a raging chorus. Shouting last orders. But don't worry, folks, they'll be back again with their mums, their wines, and stories of good old drinking time.
Tom, are you on tenterhooks?
I am.
Well, it's getting close. At 3, it's down 1 for Four Chords and the Truth again with Bonnie, Susie Clellan, The Wedding Reel, Hannah's Reel and MacArthur's Road.
Will they ever take number 1?
Oh, one day.
Perhaps. At 2, it's down 1 for Sinead Connolly with Eileen Ogg.
Number 1!
It's a new number 1. The official
angles.
Garden Sessions number 1 is up 1, Andy Chung, The Penny Falls.
Hey. Oh.
That's all. Pockets full of jingling change, playing on the penny falls. Long summer days to waste away till my mother calls. I'll loose a fishing for a spell. On the links I'll ride the carousel. This floating world is something else, as sights and sounds undo themselves. I'll be coming to strike some piece of luck on the penny falls. For the now is turned back to dust. Here it is, that's all. Pockets full of jingling change, playing on the penny falls. Long summer days to waste away till the autumn falls. Papa Gallo's parlour on the prom. 29 was the number of the song. Always felt out on a limb because I was fighting for a prize that never was. Are we coming to strike some piece of luck, playing on the penny falls? For the now is turned back to dust. Here it is, that's all. Pockets full of jingling change, playing on the penny falls. Long summer days to waste away till the autumn falls. From the star up to you, this heart was born to time, born to chance. Won't you watch me and I watch you make the silver dance? Help me and I'll help you.
Silver dance. He'd always view my parents' hands, so I go with his heart to make commands. Imaginings I could never understand. Under Jesse Gailey's wings I'll learn to dance. I'll be coming to strike some piece of luck, playing on the penny falls. For the now is turned back to dust, here it is, that's all. Pockets full of jingling change, playing on the penny falls. Long summer days to waste away, till my mother calls. Best feeling of all, here it is, that's all. Playing on the penny falls.
Andy Chung, The Penny Falls.
Bestest feeling of all.
Andy was in the Oak earlier on this week doing a few tunes, and I heard him do The Penny Falls. Oh, it was brilliant. Crazy hearing it without the mandolin.
Nice to see him back at number one. He's beginning to rival Frank for taking these number one spots.
Yeah, he just keeps coming back. And Sinead's just this sort of wild card that just pops up randomly. No matter what Angles tries to do to stop it.
And I've tried everything.
Angles, we've come to that time again.
It creeps up on us.
It's come so fast. Time passes when you're having fun. It's time for the angle.
Well, time passes when you're not having fun as well, Jack.
Not
I think
as fast.
Time flies when you're having fun is the expression.
You pedant. Angles, get on with
What's
it.
What's your angle?
The angle this time is Bruton Town, performed by CrossCurrent.
Had two sons and a daughter dear. By day and night they were contriving to fill their parents' hearts with fear. She told her secrets to no other, but unto her brother she told them all. I think our servant courts our sister. I think they have great mind to wed. I'll put an end to all their courtship. I'll send him silent to his grave. Since my two brothers have been so cruel, to take your sweet tender life away. One grave shall hold us both together, along with you till death I'll stay.
Bruton Town, CrossCurrent. CrossCurrent features Lilius Kinsman Blake. We played Lilius in our band last week as well, did we not? The last episode.
Yeah, in Sirens. It's a pounding tune, and Angle's nice one to have dug up. Dave, what's your angle?
Well, the tune has, first of all, it's got long history of credentials. Its earliest appearance is back in the 14th century in a collection by Boccaccio, and it was in this collection under the name Isabella and the Pot of Basil. So it goes all the way back, and there's like stories of it being enjoyed by minstrels in the Middle Ages. The song starts off in Bruton Town, and it's a farmer who lives there with his two sons and
his
daughter.
Where's Bruton Town?
I have no idea where Bruton Town is. And he lives there with his two sons and his daughter's the apple of his eye. And they're sitting there one night, and they're all chatting away. And one of them pipes up with this secret that they've not told to anyone else, tells it to the, to the brothers and says, I think there's something funny going on. I think one of our servants is trying to court our sister. There's sort of an inkling that they've maybe got it in their heads to get married. And basically, this can't happen.
Why?
This is not on. Servants marrying farmers' daughters? No, we know this doesn't work.
We've been here before.
We've been in this kind of territory before.
No, we've had beggars trying to get
together with farmers' daughters. This is a servant.
Oh, Matty Groves.
Matty Groves.
Oh, no, was that a
No, that was a servant done
so a lady.
But it's the same kind of scale, you see.
Right, okay.
Anyway, in this case, it
class
can't
is going to be a lot more
The
delineated.
Two brothers are just like, no, this is not going to happen. So the brothers form this plan. Basically, it's an evil, vicious, murderous plan. And they schedule a day to go off hunting in the thorny bush. Where the briars grow, and they take the servant with. They dress it up as a hunting expedition. They take the servant with them. He's probably
always
he's probably
a good
expecting
ruse.
That he's going
to
be. He's
if you
be,
want to get up to something mischievous,
dress up as hunting.
We're on a hunt.
But he obviously expects to be carrying the deer back after they've been shot, or you know, doing some butchery or something like that. You know, whatever it is that servants are expecting to do. But no, they've decided they're taking him out there, and they're not coming back with him alive.
Good God.
So they kill him.
For what? Because his sister took a fancy to him?
Yeah, pretty much.
How do they kill him?
There's no struggle. They just...
So he doesn't even see it coming?
It's two on one. No, he's expecting to be doing his servantly duties, you know.
The coward.
Carrying the shotguns or the...
Just because he took a fancy to one of their sisters?
Yep.
Good God.
And they throw his body into the woods and leave it there. And they go home and they're carrying their spoils back with them.
Seems
and,
such a nice song.
It was lovely, but
it was quite upbeat, as I remember.
Well, that's but that's the thing. You kind of it's the underlying evil that's most prevalent throughout the entire thing. They get back and they knock and then they go in. The sister says to them, "Where's the servant? Where is he? I mean, has he not come back with you?" And they say, "No, we left him behind. We've been hunting. We left him behind where no one's ever going to see him again." So they're quite blatant about it. They basically say, "Yeah, we killed him."
Did they not try?
I know you were in love with him, but now he's dead. Now
did they not try and couch it in nice terms? Though we just left him behind. Sorry.
No. They say, "Well, we killed him, but we brought you back some venison for dinner." You know, like a grief basket or something.
You can dress this up for everyone.
Is venison
like.
you know, compensation.
Well, it depends how much you like venison.
Did their sister like him too?
Yeah.
Is that implied?
Yeah. They were courting.
They were courting, yeah.
In the first verse, it goes on about how they're thinking about maybe
getting married.
He
wasn't just pestering her.
No.
They don't say that they killed him, though. They just say they left him where no man could find him. I mean, he could have just disappeared down a hole in the ground.
It's implied that he's dead.
Some kind of Bermuda Triangle of the forest.
But anyway, she gets the gist, at least, because she runs off and she's crying and lamenting her lost love and all that kind of thing. And then she goes to sleep. She has this dream. She sees him beside her, all covered in blood and gore. And she gets up the next day really, really early, and she heads out straight away.
Angles, you're just paraphrasing the lyrics.
There's not much to explain in that particular...
I just found myself reading these lyrics, and you're just paraphrasing.
He was all covered in, blood and gore.
This bit's fairly straightforward.
All covered
o'er. In the bits that don't require much explaining, I tend to paraphrase them so we can skip through it quickly without getting marred down in the boggy depths of pedantry. So she knows what's happened, and she heads out the next morning because she's seen it in a dream, and she goes off to where she thinks she's going to find him, and she finds him, and he's dead, and he's covered in blood, and it's not very nice.
Right, so he is dead.
Yeah, okay. He's pretty much stone dead, and it's rather upsetting.
They didn't hide him very well.
Yeah,
but she don't even have to dig him up.
No, but she saw it in a dream. She knew exactly where to find him.
Wait a minute. This is the one bit of the story that I'm struggling to get my head around.
So she saw it in a dream.
She knew where to go in a dream.
She saw it in a dream. Yeah,
Servant acting from beyond?
Jack, now you see you're right. I shouldn't have paraphrased it because you obviously didn't understand what I was saying. I should have done it in more detail so you'd follow, because this is what's gotten you wrong.
So she saw the servant in a dream.
Yes.
Dead.
Yes.
So is the servant acting from beyond the grave, or did they just not hide him very well and she thought, well, I'll go out into the woods anyway to see what I'll find.
No, she knew exactly. She got up early the next morning.
They just dumped him in the middle of a big clearing or something.
And she went straight into the woods.
It's supernatural.
There's certainly supernatural elements to it.
That's as may be, but we'll come back to that shortly.
Okay.
So she's crying and stuff, and she gets a handkerchief, and she's crying into her hanky, and it's all terrible. And then she says, she sort of proclaims her love by saying, "Because my brothers have been so cruel, and they've taken your life away from you, then I want to be buried with you." She says, "One grave shall hold us both together, and along with you, till in death I'll stay." So basically, she says, "I'm going to stay here till I die, and then die."
Angles, you're almost getting emotional.
And die with you.
Is that a tear?
Is that a tear that blends Angle's E?
No, it's not.
Good
it's
God, it's a sad song, though.
It's the salty, bitter taste of disgust exuding from me at all this emotion that's flying around.
What's the moral, Angles?
Well, I think getting back to the supernatural thing, the moral is that that love's so strong that it's scary enough to come back from the afterlife and infect your dreams.
No.
Could it not be that, you know, just... shouldn't let your family interfere with your affairs.
Love is more important than social standing. You know?
No.
That kind of thing. No. I'm sure listeners would agree. Yeah. In fact, if you can come up with a better moral than that.
Best Angle wins one glass eye.
One glass eye's album.
That doesn't mean we're going to come round and poke out one of your eyes.
Entries to podcast at gardensessions.co.uk. Dave, is that your angle?
Yes.
And whilst we're in the mood for the whole competition and the angle...
Last time round, we had a little bit of a problem with why Jock Stewart might have shot his dog.
Yeah.
What song was that again?
If you're in a song, you say that you're going to shoot your dog, explain.
Yeah, you explain why.
And it didn't.
And we basically asked you, if you could think of any good reason why Jock Stewart might have shot his dog, then send it in.
We had quite a lot of really quite amusing and some quite morbid entries.
We did, but we picked this one purely for the depth of thought that's got into why the dog might have been shot. And it says, "Dear Garden Sessions, I think I would shoot the dog after he ate my Aran sweater. Then I would make a new Aran sweater from the skin of the dog, taking good care to pierce the armholes in the place where the bullets had entered aforementioned dog." So there you go, that's first use of dead dog, new Aran sweater. "Then I would eat the rest of the dog." That's second use of dog.
I suppose nothing's going to waste.
Or maybe sell him to a Chinese takeaway and order him later with some noodles and soy sauce
Angles.
And those little prawn cracker things.
Oh, you've brought the mood down.
I think it's presence of thought. You know,
apologies.
I don't know how to butcher and cook dogs, so we sell them to the Chinese. They'll do it for me, and I'll get some noodles and soy sauce and prawn crackers.
Who sent this, Angus? And what did they win?
This is.
Did you authorise this prize?
I did. I picked it myself. This was sent in by Gustav Bertha from Switzerland.
From Switzerland.
And you're going to win a copy of Barak's album in Unstoppable.
Indeed.
Which is going to be winging its way to you.
That's the letters back. That's all that kind of stuff. It's time to go for our featured artist now. Tom, this week's featured artist, Alan Hunter.
Alan Hunter. I believe the word we mentioned was... Abrasive, Jack.
Yeah, abrasive. Would you say, Angles? Abrasive?
I would say on a scale of 1 to 10, then he's probably like around about 7. As abrasive as a cheese grater.
On an abrasive scale?
As abrasive as a cheese grater.
I'd give him 4 Brillo pads out of 5.
Okay, let's hear this week's featured artist, Alan Hunter. Song we're going to hear from this evening. He's the featured artist in the Garden Sessions this week and joins me downstairs in the Oak. as all our featured artists seem to do. Hello, Alan.
How are you doing, Jay?
Not too bad. Good to have you with us. Do you want to tell us a little bit about that song that you just sang, the Long Grey Line?
It's a story about a guy that I met who had an inclination against the travelling people for no apparent reason. And he had never been out of the Lothians in his life. And I met him, and then a few days later spent the night with a bunch of travellers having a marvellous session round a campfire, just talking to them. And the Long Grey Line is one of the names that the travellers have for the road. It sprung from that.
Now, you play in the Oak every second Saturday, and on other occasions when you're filling in for other people and so on, and you also do other sessions around the town. And people have been known to call your style an abrasive one. I don't know whether possibly best if you explain why they might say that.
I think they're probably right, because I'm very in your face. What you see is what you get.
Yeah.
I call a spade an effing shovel. I have no problem with anyone except those that have a problem with the world.
Yeah.
You know, and we're here. You might be lucky, you might not. You're going to sing songs, you're going to play tunes, you're going to enjoy yourself. That's what it's all about. That's why we're here. We're not here to set the world to rights, so why bother to try? I mean, we've all got our opinions, but no.
Well, the sessions in the Oak certainly always go down a storm. How do you find the folk acoustic kind of circuit around Edinburgh and out with Edinburgh?
I'm allowed to mention anywhere else by name.
Of course.
Sandy Bells, allow singers. Don't come after me for that. I think the folk circuit in general is picking up a great deal. It's marvellous.
Do you reckon we could be on for another folk revival?
I think so. Because I'm seeing some young people. And when I say young, I mean 17, 18, 19. Good fiddlers, good guitarists, good singers, singing in the folk tradition, and I love it.
Yeah.
I love to see that.
We're going to go on to your second song now, which is Whisky Before I'm Gone. Do you want to tell us a brief bit about that, why you're going to sing that for us?
I lost my mother recently. Everybody does. Sooner or later, you lose people close to you. But that's what this song's really about. It was another period of bereavement in my life when I wrote this song. But a girl just along the road from me that I didn't even know at the time, we became friends subsequently and still are friends, but I saw her putting this candle in the window night after night when I was going home from the pub. Saw her putting it there, and just something inside me told me this is a bereaved person, you know, this is a fellow traveller, and sadness kind of thing, if that doesn't sound too much like pish. But that affected me, and we ended up being good friends. But the song's basically about not giving up. Sadness comes to everybody.
Well, let's hear that now. This is called Whisky Before I'm Gone.
Whiskey chase away the tears before I'm gone. Tears of emptiness, I'm waking all alone. Stop me searching for a place I can't return. Whiskey chase away the tears before I'm gone. Whiskey chase away the tears before I'm gone. There's a candle in the window down the road. It's the one who lights it very heavy low. Second, not on
Should I laugh or should I cry or should I sing? For a man can't catch a word inside a ring. If you'll answer me, a tear to you I'll bring. With another glass, another song to sing.
Whisky before I'm gone, Alan Hunter, and I'm still sitting here with Alan downstairs in the Oak, the grand old Upper folk, and he's our featured artist this week. Can I ask you a little bit now, because this comes up quite a lot in a lot of the stuff that you do, and we've already heard it in some of the songs that we've listened to. Politics and folk music.
Inevitable combination. Folk music, take the title of that, the music of the people. And the people have plenty to complain about, and the politics of the time is one of these things. And that's why so many folk songs are heavily political. For simply that reason. It's just people complaining or boasting or bragging, but it's what the political ongoings of the time happen to be. Now, whether that's a good thing or not, it's a matter of opinion. But it is a fact. They are inseparable.
Have you ever found that anyone's going to take an issue with something that's been maybe within your songs or that you've been suggesting through the music and on any of your sessions or gigs that you've done, that anyone's taken issue with it on a political...
I've found that from time to time. Mostly not, because most people are sensible enough to realise that everybody's entitled to an opinion. You might not agree with someone, but you've got to... You've got to uphold their right to voice their opinion, whether you agree with them or not. I would rather someone disagreed with me than just didn't voice an opinion at all. I think, well, does that mean you just don't care? Let me hear your opinion. It might be just as good as mine, even if it's different.
And that's gone back all the way, though, as far as traditional songs that you sing as well. I mean, you see...
Without a doubt. I mean, one of the standard songs that you get asked for quite a lot if you're in this business is "Ye Jacobites by Name." People think that's a Jacobite song, and it's not. It's an anti-Jacobite song. I'll sing it, even although my ancestors were Jacobites. I'll sing Jacobite songs as well. I'll sing Irish Republican songs. And I have, on one occasion, sung "God Save the Queen." But
which occasion?
But
you heard it here first.
That the fee was astronomical. And had it not been, the song would never have been sung. Every now and then you have to think of the mic manager and keep him happy.
Of course, our disagreement with the song is not on a political level. It's purely because it's a pretty crap song.
Of course.
We're going to go on to the last song that we're going to hear from you, alas, which is called "Maggie Broon," another original. Tell us a little bit about that.
Maggie Broon was the first girl I ever actually went out with, and we were just young kids at Dunoon Grammar School, and our idea of a great date was going down to the ice cream shop and walking along the road holding hands, which was incredibly adventurous for kids of that age. In that, although now apparently enough said, But one night during the summer, we went to look at the stars, giving each other a kiss and a cuddle under a tree and looking. And fell asleep. And her brothers decided that I had destroyed her chastity and, you know, you know, nothing of the kind had happened, but this idea was lodged in their minds. And for quite a while, Dunoon wasn't a safe place for me to be. they're good
guys. Are there many safe places for you to be?
One or two, yeah. Well, I wouldn't list the Royal Oak on the safe places for me to be, because this place has caused me more trouble than I could possibly describe.
Yeah, you still come back here.
I'm a glutton for punishment.
Time after time. Yeah. Everyone does that. That's the way of the Royal Oak. Thanks very much, Alan.
Nice speaking to you.
And yourself.
It was underneath the ruined tree. I was drunk and so was she. Your brother's five come after me. That's why I left Argyle. In truth, I was a wretched name, and so I fled east in the sea. But sometimes, if I'm feeling brave, I go home for oil. Maggie Broon, the bonny bell, I wonder who to love you, dear, dancing in the bonny Maggie Broon. I find it hard still to believe a name and rank I am bereaved, and now the world cannot perceive a disappointed man. But yet I see the solemn truth, the price of a forbidden fruit is clarified in modern truth, and now I understand. Maggie Broon, Maggie Broon, the bonny bell of old Dunoon, I love you dear, haunting in my bonny Maggie Broon. So if you want to get along, obey the rules, do nothing wrong, there'd be a moral to the song if I could think of one. Well, the same though, here's a slice that very well and learned advice, a wise man thinks more than twice before he has his fun. Maggie Broon, Maggie Broon, the bonny bell of old Dunoon, I love you dear, haunting in my bonny Maggie Broon. Maggie Broon, Maggie Broon, the bonny bell of old Dunoon, I love you dear, haunting in my bonny Maggie Broon.
Alan Hunter, this week's featured artist on the Garden Sessions. People who know Alan will probably be wondering how on earth we managed to cut his interview down to just 15 minutes.
Well, abrasive is the word, Jack. There's no question
indeed
about that.
Fantastic interview. One of the best we've had, I'd say, on brilliant. The Garden Sessions.
Podcast!
That time again.
That time again. Creeps around.
Alas, it's the end of the show.
Next show will be episode 26 of the Garden Sessions, gardensessions.co.uk. Contact us at podcast@gardensessions.co.uk, and we'll have all of this stuff that you've heard on this show. We'll have the folky news, Dave's angle, the
what
official Garden Sessions download chart.
Will Chung still be at one?
The letters bag, and our competition, of course. You can win One Glass Eye.
One Glass Eye's album. If you'd come up with a better moral for Bruton Town than Dave did.
And we'll also have another featured artist who will hopefully rival the entertainment threat that we got there from Alan Hunter.
Well, join us next time anyway. And thanks very much to our Radio Britfolk listeners who are with us as well.
You.
So you can hear the podcast as usual on www.gardensessions.co.uk, as well as all the information about the podcast, lots of free music, news, reviews and all things folk. And now you can also download the podcast from www.radiobritfolk.co.uk.
Yes.
Till next time, I'm Jack Foster, Tom Harland, Dave the Angles Gimble.
Catch you later down the folky trail.
Good night.
Take it easy.